What's up? What you doing? I got a new guitar! I got a new guitar! And it was right in my budget in the last week of freaking April, man. Forget about it. Some might say it's not worth writing home about, but it has sustained for days. It has sustained for days. It was pretty cleaned up, or cleaned up really well. There's only a couple of spots. There's a little love, a little love there, but otherwise the edges are freaking fine. It has black binding. Seems like it has black binding if that's not the paint, but, and it's blue. It's done in blue. It's nice blue. I don't think the camera's gonna do it justice. You can see it a little bit, but it's more of a, from what I'm seeing in the camera, you're getting a deep blue. Like almost a regular blue. This is a little bit more aquamarine. So that is a little off. And the name of the puppy. Is a rogue. Now the thing is that I was all happy. I'm still happy. I mean, I'm still happy. The neck is phenomenal. I mean, it's. Number one, it's gorgeous. And it's in great freaking shape all around. I mean, all around, dude. Nope, wrong way. You know what I'm saying? All around. let's see. Open tuners at the headstock. It's a decent thing. I can't remember if I had. I did have the specs up, but it's nothing. Nothing spruce. There's some spruce in it and some other woods, but it's wood. It's mostly wood construction, and. Which is good, right? I think it's like a mahogany neck. Don't freaking come back on me on that one. But that one had a mahogany. It was mahogany everything. So that's possible. The rosette is basically a decal. All right, let's get that out of the way. This little thing is a little ditty piece of plastic. The bridge is okay. I don't know what it is. It could be plastic. I don't know. It's a beginner's guitar. Let's get that out of the way. The other thing is new. This thing is only like $59. Okay? Which is great. I mean, if you're looking for a practice guitar for classical, this is great. This is not like an ovation applause or anything like that where it has a rounded neck, a rounded radiused fretboard. And from what I understand by watching one of Wasserman's freaking videos, if you're doing classical guitar, it wants to be flat. It should be flat, right? Everything should be flat, and it's all conducive for the fingers over here. The left hand, not so much. Really, it's really difficult to bar a chord up here. So basically, you're going to be doing adult chords, jazz chords, and stuff like that when you work with this. Am I going to keep it that way? Probably not. Let's be honest, because I'm not I'm not going to wind up staying in that genre.
Damn.
Are you kidding me? So, I thought it was a great freaking deal. And they had it up there for $29.99, I think it was. So it was like $31.60, tax included, all together. And it is basically as big, a little narrower, actually here. It's actually... something. The dimensions are almost the same as the resonator that I bought for the Rogue resonator that I bought. But plays great. I remember the guy was going, there were no strings on it or anything like that. When I got there, he was setting it up because I bought it overnight and I went to go pick it up. So when I got down there, he was just throwing these strings on and stretching them out and setting it all up. And the neck was like freaking phenomenally clean, like clean. I mean, this thing is so damn clean that the plastic is still on the truss rod nut. Few things. One, the action is nice down here. Then it gets really funky, crazy up here. Now I don't know if that's because it's doing the same thing as my resonator, where the body basically just caved in. I haven't really taken a straight edge to it yet, but I'm inclined to say that that's close to the truth. You know what I mean? That's really what's going on there. And since I really don't play too much there with my fingers, I'm not going to really worry about that too much unless it starts messing around with the action up here, which I might mess with anyway, but not really too much. I mean, damn near dimed over here at the it'll hold the pick, you know what I mean? It's so low it'll hold the pick. So I mean, and if I'm gonna be treating it like a blues guitar, that'll be that. I think so. That's that. So the only other alternative that I was thinking of doing is not messing with particularly with the neck, because when I take a straight edge and I go from here to there, it's fine. Okay? If I take that same straight edge and go down to the bottom registers, so over here you have one of these things going on, you know? It's just doing that. It's going down. The body is caving while the neck is fine. So, and the only other way to get to that is to freaking, you know, what I did before was I just got some blocks and I shimmed it up, you know, a little bit. You can't really go too crazy, so you're only going to bring it up maybe about, depends. If I can get almost an eighth of an inch, it'll bring it up almost, you know, where it is here. At the ninth fret. I don't know what to tell you outside of that. 9th floor. So that's that. The other thing is that, you know, since Wasserman was saying that, you know, that was conducive to fingerstyle picking and stuff like that, that's pretty much how you want it. He's saying that if you freaking arched the saddle here, that it would cause undue stress on the body. I don't know how true that is, but we're gonna find out, because that's what I'm gonna freaking do. Because I gotta radius this, and I'm gonna bring the whole thing to a 12-inch radius. Now I don't know if I'm gonna radius the frets, because they're so damn low. I mean, I could try it, but just radius the frets instead of radiusing the whole fretboard. Instead of yanking the frets, you know, and just instead of yanking the frets, just radius them. I don't know. We'll see. Because then, I don't know. We'll see. I don't know. You have any suggestions? Let me know. Because I have no freaking clue. I really don't. China, I would imagine. I can't imagine it being made anywhere else, like where else, like Indonesia, something like that, because that's the way that price range is just amazing, you know. Rogue, made through Guitar Center, who's owned by, who is that, not Guitar Center, Musician's Friend, and they are, and they own Musician's Friend Guitar Center. So it's called an RAGBL. I guess the BL is for blue. And it's RAG. RAG. So I don't know what RAG means, but if it's supposed to be, yeah, made in China. If it's supposed to be like RAG time, then, you know, then this is an old school thing. I could pretty much do whatever the hell I want with it, you know. And at $29, I'm not selling it. I'm definitely going to keep it. So, but, and do whatever the hell I want with it. And I was looking to get one just so I could freaking do my own, make my own resonator. But this is so nice. I can't see me freaking. Oh, don't hack it up, Dan. Leave it. Leave the damn thing alone. So, that is the deal. That is the Rogue RAGBL. $59 new, okay? So, and then this was like $29. And it, like I said, it was pretty much new. Pretty much new. It's got a couple of spots here and there, but for the condition that it's in, it's damn near new, so I'll take it. You know, at that price, what are you freaking, you'd have to shoot me to freaking say no. No dots, no dots, no markers on here, but we can always take care of that, right? What the hell? But it does have side markers and everything like that, and I've already done my 15-minute spiel there. So, I will let you go, my friends. I don't know if I should, the open tuning, open tuners. It's nice. I mean, it's nice. I mean, like I said, if there was anything you want to do when you first get them or whatever, is the tuners are whacked, chuck them. Get new tuners. Or just oil the tuners. Oil the, here, take them off, put oil in around the spindle, okay, underneath the bushing or ferrule or whatever the hell this thing is here. And make sure it's well lubricated, because they're cheap. They're cheap, you know? I mean, it's just a plastic knob with the freaking hardware, and it's cheap, okay? I'm pretty sure this is probably just a plastic nut, like here, and a plastic nut over there. So, you know, but the neck is everything, and the neck is in great shape, so. But take care of that if you do decide to get one of these. Lubricate the freaking tuning heads, because they will give you problems. They will give you problems because they're cheap, okay? So, or invest, you know, another $30 and get yourself a good set of freaking tuning heads. And that's pretty much it. Outside of that, you know, freaking just have a ball with the damn thing. I am. No, it's not electric. It's not electric. I might. Debating on it, putting a transducer underneath here that I got from my old Ovation and using that. But that's, you know, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how the neck comes out. Alright, so peace. Later, people. Have a good one. Enjoy your freaking new guitars. Whatever the hell else you're getting. And I'll talk to you later. Well, as soon as I figure out what else is going on. Peace! ¶¶